Okay, today is day two of having this Harlequin Tuskfish from Australia. Just to show you the date and time, July 4th. So far the Harlequin looks like it's doing really well. It's been swimming around as of this morning and it's cruising around. Oh, look at that yawn, big old yawn. Anyhow, it ate last night, and I'm only going to be feeding them once a day. But from here on out, I'm also going to continue to do daily water tests, and just to make sure that the water parameters are going to continue to stay as optimum as possible, and I'm going to keep a close watch on the Harlequin, make sure it's not doesn't have any complications with any kind of breathing, scratching, or darting of any sorts. Check to see if there's any kind of behavior changes. So far, it's just a little bit bashful. And once in a while, it'll go and hide behind the rock there in the corner, a big shell-like rock. That's to be expected with a fairly new fish to an aquarium, getting used to his environment, unsure of the person standing there watching him, stuff. So, anyhow, well, let's just go ahead and I'm gonna pan the camera up and show you that I'm gonna be testing the water now. Straight out of the aquarium. It's interesting, every single time the fish sees me shaking the these little beakers, test vials, it goes and hides behind that rock. Maybe it thinks I'm gonna try and catch it or something, I don't know. I mean, that's also to be expected for any fish to wanna find refuge in hiding places when it gets into an aquarium with rocks and hiding spots that look closer to home. They don't want to be captured again. That's what I'm assuming anyhow. I just turned the lights on so I can show you a clear reading. With today's ammonia between 0 and 0.25 parts per million. Nitrate, we got 0. Looks like we got a little bit of a spike in the nitrate levels since yesterday. It went from 0 to now it's looking at more between at like 20 now. I may have to throw my nitrate reactor back into the tank so the nitrate levels don't get extra high. All right, and I may have to feed a little bit less as well. For the pH, it's about the same between 8.0 and 8.2. For the phosphate levels, that looks like it has stayed the same at like 0.25. We're at 1.022 for salinity. Every once in a while, I will periodically add just a little bit of salt in the auto top off. Sometimes I won't add any at all. And just to keep the salinity levels balanced in the aquariums. So it's about feeding time, and July 4th, this is day two, and it's about almost 7 o'clock, and I'm going to try and feed the Harlequin Tusk some krill, along with the brine shrimp and mysis, and see what happens. It tends to go in hiding every now and then. Every time I come up to the tank, still a little bit shy. Maybe it'll come out if I entice it with a little bit of brine or krill. There we go. Maybe drop a piece of krill in there. Maybe it'll get it. Oh, before the clownfish gets it. Darn it. Darn clownfish. At least it's eating. Maybe I can get this one here. Oh, it looks like it got the piece of krill that floated away. And the angelfish, or the butter. Clownfish didn't get it. Grab it. Go get it. It'll get it. There it goes. Yay, it's eating krill. Go get it. Oh. Alright, so far the Harlequin looks really good and it's eating and it looks healthy and healthy appetite, so that's a good thing. Alright, day 2. Thanks for watching.